Hi, I'm Leon with Audio Advice, and today we're going to show you how to attach a ground wire to your Rega turntable in case you have a system where you're getting some hum. Now, Rega believes in doing the ground on the left channel of the phono cable, and so if you have all Rega gear, like a Rega phono stage and a Rega amplifier, you'll never have to worry about this. And actually, in about 99% of systems, you won't have to worry either. But every once in a while, there's a product that does the ground differently that you're attaching your turntable to, and you may need to add one of these little ground wires, and we're going to show you how today. So what you're going to need first is a little piece of ground wire. Now, if you purchase your Rega turntable from Audio Advice and are having this trouble, let us know. We'll send you a length of ground wire that's already stripped and ready to go. So this is a tiny piece of stranded wire. This is actually 22 gauge. For your information. In this case, we're going to show you if you have a Rega phono stage and you're going into an amplifier receiver that maybe is grounded differently. All you have to do is use this grounding post on the back of the phono stage, wrap the wire around it, tighten it up. Then if your amp or receiver has a grounding post, just loosen that up and tighten it down, and that should fix it. Now, if your amp or receiver does not have a grounding post, what you're going to want to do is find a little screw on the back that's attached to the chassis, loosen it just a little bit, take your wire, loop it over it, and then tighten it back down. And that basically does the same thing as attaching it to the grounding post. So the next situation may be where you don't have a Rega phono stage and you're going into an amp or receiver and you may be using its phono input or another brand of phono stage. So you're going to have to actually attach the ground wire to the left channel audio cable. And the Rega cables have little slots in them, and so what you want to do is take the wire and just put it under two like this, and then this is the left channel, so we're going to plug this in to the left channel. Now what that has done is attach the ground to the channel here, and then take the other end of the wire, and in this case we do have a ground plug here, and we connect it. Or if you did not, it's just like in the previous step. You'll loosen up one of the chassis screws, wrap the wire around it, tighten it back down, and you should be good to go. If you found this video helpful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel. On our channel, we test out all kinds of great home audio and home theater gear. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.